Factorials, a la Shmoop. Hi, I'm Five. Meet my friend, Five Factorial. We're gonna tell you all about factorials.
We're gonna tell you all about factorials!
Right. So, a factorial helps you determine how to organize or arrange a large number of items.
A factorial helps you determine how to organize or arrange.
Whoa, why are you yelling?
Because there's an exclamation point after my name. It's kind of my thing.
Of course. Well, tell you what, I'll take it from here.
Suit yourself.
A factorial, as my friend here mentioned, ends in an exclamation point. However, the exclamation point, for once, is not being added for emphasis or because factorials are particularly exciting.
Hey!
It is just a symbol which indicates that the number you are dealing with is in fact a factorial. For example, the number 4 factorial really represents 4 times 3 times 2 times 1.
How is that helpful?
Glad you asked. Say you're going to see your favorite band, Troll Slayer, in concert. The band is great, but they've only written 4 songs. Death Tongue, Anvil of Evil, Scorpion Love, and Hate Shroud. It isn't tough to figure out what kind of music they're going to play.
That's better.
But try figuring out in what order they will play their 4 songs. We know you've got your fingers crossed that they open with Scorpion Love. Then segue into Anvil of Evil, follow that puppy up with Hate Shroud, and finally bring the house down with Death Tongue. But that's only one possible set list. How many possibilities are there? Well, there are 4 options for their opener. Once their first song has been determined, there are only 3 options for their second song, then only 2 options for their third, and lastly, a single option left for their big finale. There are 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, or 24 possible orders for the band's set list. Make sense?
Sure, but what if the audience wants an encore?
I don't think they're ready for that kind of math.
Good call.
We're here to see Troll Slayer.